All right, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. I'm grateful that we have a break in the weather. It's been raining like the last 2 days straight, and I haven't been able to get out to do a show for you guys. But I'm back today, and we're going to talk about an important subject that both you and I and our plants are made of, and that's calcium. So calcium is a real important nutrient. It's like the backbone to our plants, and literally it is the backbone to us. Calcium is the most abundant mineral in the body. You know, our bones, our teeth. You know, we need calcium to be strong. So, you know, many people in our society or many companies would want you to think, you know, hey, drink milk for our calcium. You know, and you know what? Do we need to get our calcium from our milk? Well, you know what? Let me tell you something. The bok choy right here in front of you that I grew has 4 times the amount of calcium than milk. 4 times. So it's four times as much calcium than the milk by calorie. So, you know, do you want to eat something that, you know, has 4 times the amount of calcium or, you know, 1 time? So bok choy has way more calcium than the milk. All right, so now I'm standing here in front of my broccoli. And did you know that broccoli has 2 times the amount of calcium by calorie than milk does? So 2 times, you know, that's double the amount of calcium in the broccoli. So this is broccoli that's been going to flower. You know, the heads, you know, usually are tighter than they start to open up and go to flower. But you know what? These are edible. Taste just like broccoli. And the one thing that you don't know about, most people don't know, is that these are the broccoli leaves. And they look like kale or collard leaves. And you could use them as such, you know, use them raw, juice them, blend them, cook them up or whatever. But, you know, they're also, they have 2 times as much calcium as milk by calorie. So I'm sitting here next to some of my favorite greens in the world. These are collards. I'm not sure. I think these might probably Georgia collards. I love Georgia collards. They're one of my favorite. You could use them as wraps and so many other things. But you know what? Guess how much calcium collards have? Well, they have almost 3 times as much calcium as milk. Now we're in my backyard and we're looking at one of my other favorite greens that's really rich in calcium, arugula. So this is my arugula. It's starting to go to flower now, but my ones in the front have been flowering, and actually some of the other ones in the front have actually gone to seed pod. They're making seed pods now. So these are, you know, this is arugula leaves, and this stuff is really rich in calcium. It's probably one of the richest plant sources of calcium. This has 6 times more calcium than milk by calorie. So arugula is really rich in calcium. And you know, the other thing is, you know, so you saw, you know, arugula has 6 times, bok choy has 4 times, collards have 3 times, broccoli has 2 times. And you know, while these leafy greens that I mentioned, you know, have more calcium than milk, many other leafy greens and other, you know, plants, fruits and vegetables also have calcium, but these are the extreme examples that have a lot more than milk. And while we're talking about that, you know, I want to ask, you know, where does the calcium in the milk come from? Well, it comes from the cow, right? Well, yes, the milk comes out of the cow, but you know, the cow just didn't automatically make the calcium. I mean, people can't really make minerals happen. I wish. So the cow got the calcium from somewhere. So, you know, in nature, cows would naturally eat grass, for example. So cows eat the grass, and guess what? Grass has calcium. So we could also eat grass. I don't recommend doing that unless maybe you're juicing it. But you know, the cow is getting the calcium from the grass. It processes it and then, you know, gives the milk, which has the calcium that is from the grass. So we could eat the grass or other plants to get our calcium firsthand instead of getting the calcium secondhand. And so, you know, that's what this show is about today, growing your calcium. So have you ever taken a calcium supplement? You know, that's where we're supposed to get our calcium from, right? A supplement. Well, maybe not. Maybe we should be getting calcium from our foods. And, you know, as I mentioned, all our foods, you know, or a lot of the greens have calcium, and actually a lot more calcium than milk, as I've just shared with you. But you know what? Where does the plants get its calcium from? Well, the plants get its calcium from the soil. So it's very important that your soil is nutritious for the plants. I mean, if you're just growing in, I don't know, the extreme example could be sand or clay, there's not a lot of nutrition in that. So you want to be adding some calcium back into the soil so your plants will have nutrition. Now, calcium is just one mineral, and there's so many different minerals on the earth. You know, I mean, the question is, should I even be adding minerals back into my soil, John? Well, you know, I have this here And this is actually from the 74th Congress Senate. And so this is a Senate document, document number 264 from the Senate 74th Congress, second session. Let's see, June 1st, 1936, by the United States Government Printing Office. 1936, Washington, D.C. So according to this document here, printed in 1936, it's basically about minerals and how our soils are devoid of minerals. And I'll read the last paragraph here for fun. It goes on to say that, you know, the soils are devoid of minerals, and the last paragraph is this. The public can help. It can hasten the change. So they're really, you know, saying that we need to, you know, act on the soils are deficient in minerals. We need to do something about it, and that the public can help, and here's how. How? By demanding quality in its food, by insisting that our doctors and our health departments establish scientific standards of nutritional value, which we know they did. We have the USDA that, you know, and the food pyramid, and we have all, you know, what the recommended daily allowances. And it says the growers will quickly respond. They can put back those minerals almost overnight, and by doing so, they can actually make money through bigger and better crops. It is simpler to cure sick soils than sick people. Which shall we choose? I don't know. Do we have sick soils or sick people in our society today? Well, you know, there's a lot of sickness. Healthcare was a big debate. I'm not going to even get into that. But, you know, healthcare is huge. And part of the problem, maybe there's not enough minerals in the soils. You know, we've been adding three minerals back into the soils. NPK, which is what major growers do. And they use a lot of, you know, herbicides, pesticides, fungicides, and all kinds of other things just to make the crops grow. But, you know, and it gives them pretty good yields. But, you know, there has been some companies I've heard that, you know, some companies like, well, I won't mention any names, but some big organic companies that grow carrots started using, right here, rock dust. And this is just one kind of rock dust, azomite, which adds those minerals back into the soil. And their yields actually, I won't say went through the roof, but definitely were significantly increased and financially viable, so that they actually now use rock dust as a standard practice from what I hear, because it increases their yield and actually is financially viable for them to buy the rock dust to put in their fields. And it made their crop, you know, much more than the price of the rock dust, or adding the rock dust minerals back into the soil. I've been a big advocate of rock dust for, you know, as long as I've been growing, because of my friend Don Weaver. You could check his website, remineralize.org, for some information on rock dust. I will soon also be having a show on, specifically on the rock dust, you know, that adds, you know, not only the calcium, but all the other minerals. And, you know, how much rock dust should you add? Because this is just literally powdered rock. It's not just calcium. It's not just, it's how minerals naturally occur in the soil, you know, that the rocks were ground up and then put in the soil. So you can't overdo this. The recommended application rate, according to the, you know, the manufacturers, are like 1 pound per every 10 square feet, or you might do, you know, 1.5 or 2 pounds to, you know, go a little bit higher. But I do, you know, a little bit more than that. So I also have here some shell flour, and this is a calcium supplement. So, you know, I do recommend you get your soils tested, and if your soils are, you know, don't have enough calcium in them, to add specifically a calcium supplement. Because I, you know, I was surprised. I've been adding rock dust for all these years, and I still didn't have, you know, enough calcium in my soils for optimal production and optimum soil fertility. Soil fertility is very important, because the rock dust has, you know, just a percentage, you know, 1.8% of calcium. So it's really not that much. These are, you know, once again, trace minerals. It's not going to do anything for you if you have really, you know, off the chart, or, you know, really abnormal, you know, low amounts of minerals. So that's why I'm going to get the oyster shell calcium, which is basically ground up oyster shells and other shells. And this is actually locally produced in Petaluma. That's just 10 miles away. So it's kind of being more sustainable, because it is a locally produced product. So I'm going to add this calcium back to my soils. That's also going to raise my bricks. You know, I did have one episode talking about bricks, and I'm hope to have a couple more talking about bricks. But bricks is, you know, not only the sugar content and the taste of your produce, but also the mineral content of the produce. You could tell that by looking at a bricks test. So hopefully you've learned more today about calcium and why your soils need calcium, and how you could grow your own calcium, you know, in your garden, and maybe not need to, you know, drink as much milk. All right, so this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com with Chico. He wants to say hi. All right, say hi, Chico. So we'll see you next time.